Back where I've already been. on the road again, going back where I've already been. You look knowing where we'll live. Here I go down that wrong road again. Here I go down that wrong road again. Here I go down that
Fairchild.
You know what? Let me just say something right there, because you know that can be confusing.
Sure.
You know,
Langdon and Will. I'm always forgetting my name. It is confusing.
Yeah,
it is.
Absolutely. But a lot of people ask us, well, if you're Will and you're Langdon, then right. Where does Wilson Fairchild come from?
It is a good question.
It's a really good question.
And the answer is, it's our middle names.
Yeah.
I'm Fairchild.
No, I... You do forget, don't you? I'm the Fairchild.
I'm Wilson.
Yeah, you're Wilson.
And he's the Fairchild.
Absolutely.
And we liked it for a couple of reasons. We wanted it to be more duo sounding. So it's, you know, Wilson Fairchild. And if the music name completely dries up and doesn't work out, we're going to open up a law firm. Doesn't that sound good?
That's nice.
Wilson it? Yeah. Fairchild.
Yeah.
And Associates.
Esquire.
Oh, that's even better.
Like a DDF, DDR, DD, or DMD, or MFR, something else.
I think it's a dentist.
That's okay, right. Yeah, Esquire and Associates. It's going to be good.
Yeah.
It's going to be professional, whatever
it's
it is.
It's a backup plan.
Exactly. Yeah.
It is.
Hey, we also want to say, too, that right up front, that we are so blessed and grateful that we get to travel the country and play a lot of different venues. But we got to tell you that playing here at the station, at the Miser Station, is the coolest venue there.
Yeah.
Good.
We love it.
Yes.
Yeah.
And we were totally joking about the way out in the boondocks and the vines and stuff, but we've been coming in through Mississippi the last couple years. And but now that we know the airport's so close, it was a lot easier to get here.
There's a lot of ways of saying what I want to say to you. There's so many promises and dreams that might come true. But I won't talk of starry skies or moonlight on the ground. I'll come right out and tell you I just love lay you down. Lay you down and softly whisper pretty love words in your ear. Lay you down and tell you all the things my woman loves to hear. I'll let you know how much you mean just having you around. Oh darling, now I'd love to lay you down. There's so many ways your sweet love made this house into a home. You got a way of doing little things that turn me home. Like standing in the kitchen in your faded cotton gown, with your hair all up in curlers, I'd still love, I'm singing, lay you down and softly whisper pretty love words in your ear. Lay you down and tell you all the things my woman loves to hear. I'll let you know how much it means just having you around. Oh darling, I'd love to lay you down. When a whole lot of Decembers are showing your face, your auburn hair is faded and silver takes its place. You'll be just as lovely and I'll still be around. And if I can, I know that I'd still love to lay you down. Lay you down. Softly whisper pretty love words in your ear. Lay you down, tell you all the things my woman loves to hear. I'll let you know how much it means just having you around. Oh, darling, I'd love to lay you down. Lay you down and softly whisper, pretty love words in your ear. Lay you down and tell you all the things my woman loves to hear. I'll let you know how much it means just having you around. Oh, darling, I'd love to lay you down. Lay you down and softly whisper, pretty love words in your ear. Lay you down and tell you all the things my woman loves to hear. I'll let you know how much it means just having you around. Oh, darling, now I'd love to lay you down.
I was trying to tell you something in private. Right in the, but you know they can still see you, right?
I mean, yeah, I guess so.
Well, what's so important that you had to sneak up on me just to say to me in the middle of a song?
Well, you know, we've been singing this song for years, right? A long time.
Right.
But I think there's some new people here tonight that have never seen us before.
Oh, yeah?
Okay. And I might have got a request. To sing this next part by myself.
I know you're lying. You don't get requests like that.
No, I did. Somebody asked for you to sing this by yourself.
Well, you know, we keep singing this song, right?
Lower and lower and lower, right?
Right.
Okay. Well, everybody knows when you're singing low like that, it's sexier for one man to sing by himself.
Really? I didn't realize that.
That was the request. They said, Will, when you get to that low part, will you sing it by yourself? I said, yes, sir, I will. Yes, ma'am, I will. I said, yes, ma'am, I will. Okay? So you play, let me sing. Let's see what happens.
Oh, really? So without me,
you just play. Softly whisper, pretty love words in your ear. Lay you down, tell you all the things my woman loves to hear. I'll let you know how much it means just having you around. Oh, darling, how I'd love to lay you down.
Earn that.
No, they started clapping before
I
started waving my hat. They did.
I think I saw the man that requested it over here.
Hey, come on now. We're all friends. This is about the music.
No,
okay?
You know, that's fine if you want to. So now is it my turn? We go back and forth?
No, it's not your turn. It was my request, okay? I'm sure somebody sometime will request you to do something.
Sure.
But it's a little bit lower. Let me sing it again.
You gonna try it by yourself?
Yeah, you never know. They might even like clap more.
It's lower, yeah.
Lady Dad, softly whisper. Lay you down, tell you all the things my woman loves to hear. I'll let you know how much it means just having you around. Oh, darling, how I'd love to lay you down.
Better watch it. It's getting heated up in here.
All right, that was fun. We can go on another song.
No, look here. I want to take it even lower.
I saw you did that.
Yeah.
So you don't think I can sing it this low?
I don't.
Really?
I tell you what, you just keep playing it right there. Yeah. Get yourself ready.
Go ahead. Okay. So, well, I'm going to do this one for you, okay?
I'll be right here.
All right, that sounds good.
I'm singing.
Play a little louder, I can't hear you.
Lay you down, softly whisper, pretty love words in your ear. Lay you down, tell you all the things my woman loves to hear. I'll let you know how much it means just having you around. Oh, darling, how
let's go on to another song.
I'm going to tell you something. I'll be honest with you right here, okay?
What?
And you're right. We're all friends now. We're three songs into this.
That's right.
None of us are impressed yet.
I was impressed.
No.
Yeah.
They're not. Look at them. Y'all want to hear it go? No, I tell you what. We've now taken this song.
Yes.
Down.
Yes.
An entire octave.
Right.
Which is about that much.
In dog years. Yes. That's a whole octave.
Come on.
So,
man.
I tell you what.
What? We'll make you this deal.
What?
If you can sing it.
Yeah.
This low.
Yeah.
One more time. We'll stop and go on to another song.
Do you promise?
I promise, because I'm tired of hearing you sing.
I don't know if I can sing it this low.
I don't think I care.
All right.
Come on.
You got one more. All right, but do me a favor.
Right.
If I pass out trying to sing it this low, just go on with the show.
I'm counting on it.
All right.
All right.
Okay. I'm going to need complete quiet.
Not you.
I think I got it.
Lay down, softly whisper pretty love words in your ear. Lay down and tell you all the things my woman loves to hear. I'll let you know how much it means just having you around. Oh, darling, how I'd love to lay you down.
You might be.
We still got a little bit more to do, though. And I called Langdon and I said, man, George Jones is coming to do a concert. It would be so much fun if we could open up that show. And he's like, well, yeah, that'd be great. But how do we do it? I said, I'll figure it out. So I found out who the promoter was on the concert, and I called the guy. I said, hey, y'all having George Jones over there next month? He said, yeah, we sure are. I said, man, you know, we're Wilson Fairchild. We'd love to open up that show. And he's like, okay. He said, I don't care if you open, but I'm not going to pay you. And we said, fine. Not a problem. We're used to that in the music business.
So that's the same thing that's happened here tonight.
Oh, exactly. Yeah, exactly. So we said, great. So we did. We got to open up that show in front of George Jones. It was so much fun to see the old traditional country music and the way concerts used to be. And if it never happened again, it was just something great that we got to do. So I noticed the next weekend on his website, he was going to be in Pennsylvania. So I picked up the phone, figured out who the promoter was. I called and said, hey, we're on tour with George Jones. What time do we open? And the guy said, I don't know who you are. I don't care if you open, but I'm not going to pay you. True story. And we said, fine, we'll be there. So we got the band, and we went to Pennsylvania and got to do another George Jones song. And that time it worked out a little bit better. We got to meet George, his wife Nancy, and everybody in the band, and told them, said, hey, you know, we'd love to do this any show you've got. So for the last 3 or 4 years when he was still touring, we did that. We traveled around in the truck, just two guitars, and opened up a lot of his shows, and I got to be in front of a lot of people. But it was so much fun because it reminded us of years gone, that way country music used to be. But we kind of said then, when we lost Mr. Jones, that we'd always try to include one of his songs in our show. So here's one of our favorites.
Imagine a world where no music was playing. Church where nobody's praying. Have you ever looked up at the sky with no blue? You've seen a picture of me without you. walked in a garden where nothing was growing. I stood by a river where nothing was flowing. Have you seen a red rose unkissed by the dew? Have you seen a picture of me without you? Can you picture heaven without angels singing or quiet Sunday morning with no church bells ringing? Have you watched as the heart of a child breaks in two? Then you've seen a picture of me without you. Sunday morning with no church bells ringing. Have you watched as the heart of a child breaks in two? That you've seen a picture of me without you? You've seen a picture of me without you.
Myself are also songwriters. We've written a lot of songs over the years. But this next song that we're going to do for you, it's funny how this came up. We were driving in the truck. Oh, speaking of driving in the truck, you want to tell them about Truck Town?
Oh, yeah. Well, y'all saw a little bit ago.
Well, that's right.
Directions, right?
Right, with the grapevines.
Well, be sure. We have to tell you this. We have to take this time because our social media girl who tells us all, she keeps us in line with all that stuff. We don't know the difference. And, he didn't even know how to turn a computer on.
We do the dumb stuff and then hand it off to somebody else.
Anyway, we are on Facebook. So if you're on Facebook, be sure to like it. He needs a lot of friends.
Right.
And but anyway, every Wednesday, we used to do what we call Truck Time. And it's just us two riding around and solving the world's problems. And hopefully we'll make you laugh. We might even sing a song. Hard to tell what comes up, what we'll talk about. But anyway, and then, of course, our website, wilsonfairchild.com. That's all our information. You know what would be a good thing right now?
What would be a good thing right now?
Well, just because we need to get a picture.
We do. So we can post it.
Somebody want to take a picture of us so we can sure just hand it off?
Yeah, absolutely.
Yeah, sorry, this is social media stuff. We got to do it, right?
Yeah.
Yeah. Looking there. Is she good at that?
She's good. Very good.
Yeah, all right. You'll get the station. Oh, yeah, look right there.
Okay, all right, thank you.
You're gonna want to put that one on Facebook.
All right, thank you. So yeah, long story short, if you leave here tonight and you think you're missing us at any point in time, Facebook, YouTube, just come see us. So, back to the story about writing
songs. You want a picture too? Are you trying to be our new social media person as well?
We'd love to have one.
We can do it.
Yeah, absolutely.
Not her?
Yeah.
Never mind, you're fired.
Yeah. So one day Lightning said, hey, I got this great idea. Let's write a song about coyotes.
That is a great idea.
That's what he said. And I said, man, who's going to record a song about coyotes this day and age?
Nobody.
So we wrote this great Western song about coyotes and put it in the folder. Realized nobody in the world is going to want to do this song but us.
Yeah.
So now we do it.
That's right.
But we need a little help. Every time we say the word coyote in the song, we want y'all to howl. Okay? If you don't mind.
We got some overachievers.
But I can tell they've got coyotes because it sounded like it.
Yeah.
We got different little
Dino thing going on.
I think it was a wild dingo. But anyway, so you know, before anybody gets hurt, let's demonstrate for them. You say it and let me howl.
Okay.
All right.
Just wait a second.
This is merely professional.
This is kind of how it's going to go.
Okay. Coyote.
That is so weird. There was a lot of weird in that, man.
You know, when I first started, I didn't mean for it to go on that long.
Whoa, what happened?
I don't know. Something took over, like canine senses or something.
Really?
And then I could smell somebody on this mic from 1982. That was weird.
Man, you got into
it. His name was Sebastian.
Really?
Yeah.
What was that maneuver right there?
Something dripped out. I don't know.
Oh, my goodness.
I have no idea. Yeah.
Really?
I don't know.
That's terrible.
Okay.
You probably shouldn't have shared that information.
At this point, I'm really sorry.
Yeah. We apologize. This is probably our last time playing here.
You get them to howl.
Okay. You all can do it better than that. Are you? Coyote. Oh, they're a lot better.
They're naturals.
Sleeping down where the coyotes play. Oh, what a way to end the day. With my strawberry roan, I'm never alone. Time to stop and rest a while the cowboy way. A saddle for my pillow and a blanket of stars. Lying here and wondering if there's cowgirls on Mars. Thank you, Lord, for giving me just one more day. Sleeping out where the coyotes play. Sleeping down where the coyotes play. Lots of room where I can always stay. A fire warm my feet to cook the beans I eat. To be the nightlight till the sunlight dawns the day. I sleep with one eye open and a gun in my hand. Listening to the howling of the coyote man. Watching stars shoot across the Milky Way. Sleeping out where the coyotes play. Thank you.
It's jazz, baby. It's jazz. It's like I got stuck like that Hallett thing. Sleeping down where the coyotes play. Oh, what a way to end the day. With my strawberry roan, I'm never alone. Time to stop and rest a while the cowboy wins. A saddle for my pillow and a blanket of stars. Lying here and wondering if there's cowgirls on Mars. Thank you, Lord, for giving me just one more day. Sleeping out where the coyotes play. Sleeping out where the coyotes play. Some good coyotes out there.
What did you say?
What spelled like that? I think you should say coyote.
Coyote.
That sounds really funny. Coyote. 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 I had a pet coyote one time.
Really?
Yeah.
I remember that. You had a Jeep and he was huge and his head stuck out the top.
Yep, we called him Old Scoob.
And he was a what?
He was a coyote. I don't have any idea. We're just making this stuff up.
You sure there wasn't a wolf in that coyote?
It might have been.
I think it was.
I don't know.
I think he was a lot wolf.
Yes.
Hey, I want to call an audible right here.
Yeah. Let's do it.
What we doing? Well, you know, we love classic country music.
Yeah.
And somebody else that we've always loved is Ronnie Millsap. Oh, he just had great music. But here's a song that we've always liked. Yeah.
I've got some friends down in Houston. Who know me quite well. They'll be more than happy to put me up for a spell. I can hang out or hide out, whichever I choose. And they won't ask me questions about why I've got blue. I've got a Houston solution in mind. All it takes is a call on the telephone line. And I can leave all these problems in Nashville behind. I've got a Houston solution in Houston.
Exactly where we come from and who we are. We are we have some country music heritage and legacy in our family, and we're proud to say that our dads are Harold and Don Reed, of the Statler Brothers.
Thank you.
You're welcome to clap, but we didn't have anything to do with it. Actually, growing up, you know, people think it was, you know, the greatest life. Well, we didn't really have any choice but to listen to their music. And they made so much of it, you know, I mean, that's all we did. They put us in locked rooms and make us listen to their music.
Couldn't come out till we knew the whole album.
Right, exactly. Yeah. So
it was very treacherous at times, but through therapy,
yeah,
and lots of years of coping with it, we're good with it now. It's not that big a deal anymore, really. We've really grown to love their music.
And you've really grown to really like your therapist, too.
Exactly.
And you know what we got here? This is, again, we're talking about the Miser Station here, and looking around at all of these pictures and these posters and all the country music paraphernalia. Right. Like that big word.
I wouldn't talk like that in front of these people, no.
And right here, front and center, if y'all can see this, point to it, let them know. Right there is 1975, the best of the Statler Brothers album. Oh. That was their biggest selling album of all time. And our mamas are on the cover. Yeah.
So now that it's the biggest selling record, I guess they should have put our mom's pictures on all the albums.
I guess that's what that means. Music wasn't that good, but the picture was great. No, we did. We grew up loving their music and who they were to so many people. Will and I, we traveled out and watched a lot of those fairs that they played and sat on the side of the stage and knew that we wanted to do that as well because we could see the way that they would impact and influence and the kind of effect that their entertainment and their music and their lyrics had on people. And they were blessed and grateful for that. And we knew early on that that's something we wanted to do. So we did. We grew up on their music and watching what they do. And a few years back, we decided that we wanted to go into the studio and kind of do a tribute album, CD, if you will, of their songs. So we sat down and with our two dads being the primary songwriters for the group, they wrote so many songs. And we sat down and said, you know what, let's pick about 10 songs that those two guys wrote together and go in the studio with just a couple of guitars, kind of in the role, and present it to the way that maybe it sounded like after they just finished writing it. So that's what we did. We put it on a CD. It's called Songs Our Dads Wrote. Took us a long time to come up with that title. But it is one of the special pieces of music that we've been a part of. And so anyway, we wanted to maybe take the next portion of the show and play some of their music and go back to memory lane with them. How about that?
When you're lying there in bed, late at night, all alone, with nothing on but the radio, listening to the midnight man, taking telephone requests, playing songs that you and I used to know. Do you ever think of me and all the nights that we wasted and can't get back again? But if we ever do, honey, I promise you I'll even love you better than I did then. When you go for a walk in the leaves when it's cold, or lay when it's warm in the sun, with time on your hands and the memories on your mind, or a long sleepless night has just begun. Do you ever think of me and all the nights that we wasted and can't get back again? But if we ever do, honey, I promise you I'll even love you better than I did then. I'll even love you better than I did then. I'll even love you better than I did then.
Do we have any left-handed people here tonight?
Yes.
Well, yes.
You should have said left-handed women.
Yeah, that was my next question.
Yeah.
How about any left-handed women?
Back here.
Back here. All right. Okay.
Back here. I'm a left-handed woman.
I also love when you say left-handed woman and people start with the woo woo. It's like, have they ever done that before? Like, you do that everywhere you go. Yeah. So let the left-handed part, that's what this next song is about. That Langdon and I discovered this song from years ago that our dads wrote, and it was on an album. And we just thought it was cool and it was kind of funky.
Yeah.
But it's for all the left-handed women in the house.
Seen her living, then you know that when she died, you can bet she ain't breathing cause of the way she lies. She'll cry when you're leaving, but it'll laugh when you're gone. That left-handed woman is right when she's wrong. That left-handed woman is killing my soul. She's easy to handle, but so hard to hold. She's good when she's lonely and great when she ain't. That left-handed woman I love and I hate. Well, she loves being warm, and she hates being cold, and she's proud of being pretty and scared of getting old. And she likes being looked at in the early morning light. Yeah, that left-handed woman is wrong when she's right. That left-handed woman is killing my soul. She's easy to handle, but so hard to hold. She's good when she's lonely and great when she ain't. That left-handed woman I love and I hate. That left-handed woman I love.
Two more times for the night. So, hey, this is a fun story though. When we were in the studio, we go down to Nashville. We live in Virginia, by the way, and so we would go to Nashville and record some of the CD and then come back. So we had it finished up, and our dads told us. They said, you know, we want to hear this song of all the songs that they've written, and they want to hear it. So anyway, one time while we are in the studio, and it's me and Will and our producer, and we come across this next song that we've recorded, and we're going to do it here for you next. And
While the opening line to this song is, it was in the high school yearbook dated May of 55.
Right?
That's something.
So let's get something straight. We're not that old. I mean, I don't mean any disrespect. It's just like, you know, we don't sing about stuff from 1955. You know,
we're the next generation.
Yeah, we're another generation. Yes. Exactly.
So we talked then and said, you know, if we ever, what we could do to update that song and that line, we could say it was in the high school yearbook dated May of 95.
Right.
Right? And bring us up to, you know, maybe our generation. And
sure.
So we thought it was a good idea, but then we said, nope, we can't do it.
No, we're not going to do that.
Can't do it, won't do it, not going to do it, because we're not messing with those lyrics that other people wrote, especially if it's your own dad.
Exactly. Right? We just thought it was wrong. There's no way we're changing the lyric.
We still thought it was a good idea, but we said, no, we can't do that.
No way.
So anyway, then fast forward a few weeks later, we're back in Virginia. And so my dad calls me and says, hey, I want to hear some of that music. So I did, went and picked him up. We're riding around in the truck. This song comes on. We listened to the whole thing, and he said, man, that's really good. I like it. He said, do you mind if I make a suggestion? I said, no, it's your song. What do you want to say? He said, it might be a good idea, if y'all wanted to, you could change that first line to say, it was in the high school yearbook dated May of 95.
That's the first thing he said.
And I'm thinking, well, yeah, I had that idea 2 weeks ago.
Right. But we didn't want to step on anybody's toes.
So I just said, hey, that's a good idea. We might consider that.
Meanwhile, on the other side of town, because we live on the other side of the tracks from where his family lives.
Yeah.
But anyway, me and my dad are riding around in our old truck because we're on the other side of the tracks.
We do go by sometimes and throw them crumbs and stuff.
Yeah, exactly. We're listening, doing the same thing, family tradition. Dad said, oh, I want to hear that stuff you are cutting. So I played it for him, and he listened to it. He said, oh, man, that's great. He said, it brings back a lot of memories. He said, I don't want to mess in your business, but y'all could change that line to May of 95 if you wanted to. I swear. You know, they're brothers. It's a thing. So both of them said the exact same thing off the bat. I called Langan and said, man, you're not going to guess what Dad said. He said, you're not going to believe what my dad said. So we went back in the studio and fixed it and put 95 in.
Forevermore.
For everybody in the family.
It was in the high school yearbook, dated May of 95. We were voted the couple most likely to survive. Even teachers never doubted we were more than just friends. But your mama had some second thoughts back then. When you went off to nursing school, I kept my job in town to show your folks that I was old enough to settle down. And when you came home for holidays, we were happy without sin. But your mama had some second thoughts again. Does your mama know I'm rich and happy? Well, almost, that is. Has she ever said that maybe she was wrong? All she ever really wanted was to have the best of you. And that's all I ever really wanted to. And that's all I ever really wanted to. Thanks to her, she made me want to prove I could succeed. But thanks to her, I'll never have the one thing that I need. And if she reads the papers and remembers who I am, she's probably having second thoughts again. Does your mama knew I'm rich and happy. Well, almost, that is. Has she ever said that maybe she was wrong? All she ever really wanted was to have the best of you. And that's all I ever really wanted to. And that's all I ever really wanted.
Sarcastic song they ever wrote, but they got it out. Hey, a few years back, the Statler brothers were first inducted into the Gospel Music Hall of Fame, and then the very next year, they were inducted into the Country Music Hall of Fame, and they're actually one of only six artists to reside in both of those halls. And for those ceremonies, for both of them, they called Will and myself and wanted us to be a part of it and sing a song to them. And we thought right then it was the perfect time for us to finally write our own Statler Brothers song. So we did. We sat down and we put all 40 years of their music and their TV shows and comedy and awards and everything we could think of that they gave to us and to country music and put it all inside of a song. So we did that. We sang it to them for both of those events, and it was a special night for all of us. And we want to sing it for you right now. It's simply titled The Statler Brothers Song. Take a listen.
You've been called America's poets. You started out as a gospel quartet. You're entertained, holding off on the record, and your records will never forget. You sold out shows to millions, sang your part in four matching suits, and accepted your awards, and always thank the Lord in tuxedos and patent leather boots. So carry me back to Virginia, and let us hear thou break the heart again. And if you ever hear the stage a-calling, will he love you better than we did then? We love Shirley Jean Perez. Brothers, 'cause we'll go to our grave.
Thank you so much.
Thank you all. You're great. We're going to take 15-minute intermission. We're going to come back and play some more music. We'll go play.
All right. Got everybody back in here?
All the important ones.
Hardest part's getting JJ off the stage. Yeah, I think he likes it. Yeah. Speaking of that, JJ told me that we would not get paid if we didn't change the lyrics to one of our songs.
Oh, really?
Yeah.
Did we offend him somehow?
I don't think offend him.
Oh, yeah.
But he said it would sound better like this.
Oh, yeah?
Okay. Our thing at Miser Station that you thought I'd never care.
Wow, that's a lot better.
You know, since you don't do it that like often, I'm just gonna do that part again, okay?
Oh yeah, you're gonna sing it again.
Power things.
Yeah,
they do it in harmony.
At Miser Station, bet you thought I'd never care.
Yeah, it does. It's got a ring.
Yeah, it's actually really bad, but we just want to get paid.
Yeah, so we did it.
Yeah. You got that recorded, right?
We're good.
Yeah, we're good.
Y'all get that on tape?
We have witnesses.
Yeah. It went.
How are things at Miser Station?
Okay, I think that's enough. So where we're from in Virginia, we're in a little different place in Stanton. A lot of music has come from Virginia, you know? But definitely down in Southwest Virginia, you know? Old mountain music and roots music, you know? Lots of artists over the years tell stories about how their great-grandma, Mammy, Pappy, you know, used to sit on the front porch and smoke a corncob pipe and sing our old Irish tunes.
Really?
You know a lot of those stories?
No, I haven't heard a lot of that. A grandpappy? Who?
Grandmammy Pappy.
Grandmammy Pappy.
Corncob pipe.
She'd smoke a pipe.
Yeah, like the Carter family and stuff. Where those people came from.
Yeah.
You know, I mean,
that's
where, you know, music started. A lot of country music.
Kind of like roots music.
Right, roots. Yeah. Front porch roots. Right, front porch roots. That's where it came from.
Yeah.
But that's not where we come from.
No.
At all. You know, our story is a little bit different, you know, and up in Stanton, Virginia. But we would like to do an old family tune for y'all, if it's okay.
I keep hearing you're concerned about my happiness. All that thought you're giving me is conscience, I guess. If I were walking in your shoes, I wouldn't worry none. When you and your friends are worried about me, I'm having lots of fun. Counting flowers on the wall, that don't bother me at all. Playing solitaire till dawn with the deck of 51. Smoking cigarettes and watching counting kangaroo. Now tell me, I've nothing to do. It's good to see you. I must go. I know I'll go right. Anyway, my eyes are not accustomed to this light. And my shoes are not accustomed to this hard concrete. So I must go back to my room and make my day complete. Counting flowers on the wall, that don't bother me at all. Playing solitaire till dawn with the deck of 51. Smoking cigarettes and watching Captain Kangaroo. Now don't tell me I've nothing to do. Now don't tell me I've nothing to do.
Good old family tune.
Yeah.
And hey, did you realize what you were doing when you were moving in that song?
Well, you were kind of dancing. I was doing.
Well, normally when we do that song, you know, with the band and the drums do the doom, do the doom, do the doom, and that part right there. And the reason I'm moving like this, I always feel like I'm riding a camel.
Really?
Yeah.
It's neat.
And that's what I do. I feel like I'm riding a camel, and you know, it's got the humps. On that camel?
Yeah.
There's no water in there. Did you know that?
There's no water in those humps.
That's amazing.
So you were riding the camel with me, right? And you know the humps?
Yeah.
Oh.
I think it's like fatty tissue or something. Did you know that?
No, I apparently do tonight, I guess, you know? That's neat. Yeah,
but nothing like a family song makes me think of a camel.
Right.
Oh, yeah. Exactly.
And fatty tissue.
Yeah, exactly.
I think I'd hear that phrase when I woke up this morning.
Okay, that's all I got.
That's it? Then you're done?
How are things at Miser Station?
That's it. That's all I got. Hey, you know one thing that we were talking about out here?
Yeah.
I think we needed, or did you have a song you want to do right now?
No, what do you want
in particular?
No, what do you want to do?
No, well, we had an experience. You and I did a new activity and an experience today.
That's right.
That we've never done before.
Ooh, that's right.
We got invited to, and we went and threw axes.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah. Yeah. Yes, have y'all done that?
No.
It was an axe throw for the first time ever.
Check that off our list, man. We had an instruction, and they told us, you know, don't flick it. You got to follow through, and it was big time. So anyway, I'm bringing that up because number one, that was awesome. Thank you, JJ.
I know why he's bringing it up.
Oh, you do?
Yeah, because
he caught him
pretty fast, and after three matches, he beat me all three matches.
I know why he's bringing it up.
And I do want to apologize because I got kicked out of the place. Well, it was just a misunderstanding. This duck flew in the place and I threw and killed the duck.
Oh my gosh.
In midair. And they thought I did it on purpose.
Yeah.
And handcuffed and took me out of the place. It was an accident. I'm serious. It was just an accident.
But it's in litigation right now. You've called a lawyer.
Yeah, I called my lawyer, and I'm not even supposed to be talking about it. Okay. But if you get a chance, go by there.
It was fun. Just there's a little bit of duck blood there on the floor.
Yeah, right, exactly.
Past that. No, the moral of that story is that I beat Will. So just that's why. You know.
Oh yeah. Look here.
We already covered that. Thank you. Yeah. I'll bring that up again here in a little bit as well.
Okay.
Yeah. What anything here? What else we want to do? What
you pick. Here? You pick.
I pick?
Yeah.
Yeah.
Well, is that what you're going to do?
I don't know.
Do it.
You want to? Y'all want to?
Yeah.
Just do it. Just.
Yeah.
Don't ask.
Come on,
me.
Do it.
At this bar on the interstate, when a guy with this bird on his shoulder walked through the door. Well, he proceeded to tell me the wildest thing. He said, "Sir, this bird of mine can sing like no other bird that you've ever heard before." Well, I kind of looked at the guy and said, "Oh, really?" He turned to that bird and said, "Do old Willie." When the bird started singing, I almost fell on the floor.
Whiskey River, take my mind. River, don't run dry. She's all I got to take care of me.
Well, I thought, son, what a heck of a thing. Man, get rich making that thing sing, and I can feel this wild idea coming on strong. And besides, I'm sitting here with 2 weeks pay, and I'd probably blow it all anyway. And then he said, "Hey, mister, wait till you hear this bird sing like George Jones."
Ooh.
Yeah.
Go ahead.
No.
Go ahead, sing like George Jones.
I said the bird. You're the bird.
I thought you were doing George Jones.
No,
he said, "Wait till you hear this bird sing."
I'm sorry. It was like George Jones.
He stopped loving her today. Late wax wreath upon his door. And soon they'll carry him away.
That's what you did for the coyote, also. George used to do it too.
He stopped loving her today.
That'll work.
I said, well, that does it, sir. Yep. I want to buy that bird, but $500 take him off your hands. Well, he thought for a while, then he said, all right. He handed me the bird, and he said goodnight. He counted my money, and out the door he ran. Listen to this. I was thinking I found the rainbow's end, and the money would soon come pouring in. But suddenly that bird just flew out the door and was gone. And then it hit me. I got boiling mad, because I knew right then that I'd been had. And as he flew off into the night, he was singing this song.
On the road again. Just ain't waiting on the road again. The life we love is playing music on Sirius XM. And I can't wait to get on the road again.
Give me an axe!
On the road again. Just can't wait to get on the road again. The life I love is playing music on Sirius XM. And I can't wait to get on the road again. And I can't wait to get on.
True story.
Yeah,
the bird.
You know what else is kind of a little creepy? This thing back here.
Yeah.
It's also kind of creepy how much he loves it.
Yeah.
So, well, what's your deal with the Sasquatch? I mean, you love it.
Everybody's looking for him.
And there he is.
There he is.
Found him.
Yes.
Oh, okay, I get it now.
Yes. Yeah. You know, everybody says, you know, that I saw Bigfoot. I want to get like a t-shirt that says, Bigfoot saw me.
That's fascinating.
Yeah,
that's fascinating.
Turn the tables on Bigfoot.
Yeah, that's right.
Yeah. Anyway, I just, every now and then when I look over at you, I see this other person. Just thing over the corner of my eye. I'm like,
yeah, that's creepy.
Somebody's creeping over here.
Well, we're going to do some gospel music, but I really think we need a song before that. Because I don't want to go right in from creepy doing talking about Sasquatch to gospel.
It's not a good segue.
Yeah. So I think we need a segue song.
Yeah,
what is that? What is that? Oh.
Y'all know this song. Come on, sing it.
When I hear that train humming, it's rolling around the bend. I ain't seen the sunshine since I don't know when, but I'm stuck in Post Prison, and time keeps dragging on.
I know.
And that train keeps rolling all down the San Antonio.
Jump on in here, Sasquatch. Right.
When I was just a baby, my mama told me, son, always be a good boy, don't ever play with guns. But I shot a man in Reno just to watch him die. When I hear that lonesome whistle, I hang my head and cry. Rich folks eating in a fancy dining car, probably drinking coffee and smoking big cigars. Well, I know I have to come out, I know I can't be free.
So,
but those people keep moving, but that's what it told you. Thank you. far from Folsom Prison. That's where I wanna stay. And I let that lonesome whistle blow my blues away.
So the latest song that we have recorded, and actually it's not on CD, but it's everywhere else on Spotify, Amazon, iTunes, wherever you listen to music. YouTube, you can pull it up there. We went back and cut an old Crystal Gayle song and put a new twist to it. And it's called Ready for Times to Get Better. I've got to tell you, I've been racking my brain, hoping to find a way out. I've had enough of this continual rain, changes are coming, no doubt. It's been a too long time with no peace of mind, and I'm ready for the times to get better. It's been a too long time with no peace of mind, and I'm ready for the times to get better. Lonesome at times. I have a dream that I wish I could live. It's burning holes in my mind. It's been a too long time with no peace of mind, and I'm ready for the times to get better. It's been a too long time with no peace of mind, and I'm ready for the times to get better. For the times to get better. It's been a too long time with no peace of mind, but I'm ready for the times to get better. And I'm ready for the times to get better. And I'm ready for the times to get better. Thank you. The two of us. Would you like to hear another one that we wrote?
Hey, I'll tell you, this one, this is a good one. It's not bad like the other ones. I mean, it doesn't have anything to do with coyotes.
No. It was a delayed response, though, I could tell. Yeah.
It takes a little time. It's all right.
So we wrote this song a few years ago, and actually our dads did record it on the album. And but it's just a song we always loved.
Yeah, and you know what? Last week, I think, this is good. We just sang the song again last week because we were in Nashville. And actually, we were playing the Grand Ole Opry last week.
Last Thursday.
We're there with the Gatlin brothers, the Bellamy brothers, the Malpas brothers.
Oh,
okay. Yeah. And obviously, we found out they couldn't find any more brothers to be on the show. So they went for a couple of cousins.
Yeah.
That's it. But it worked out.
It worked out. We had a great time there. And then the next morning, we went on the radio with Bill Cody at WSM. Right. And so we played this song right here. Y'all ready?
It's too late for roses.
pushing up daisies. It's too late for roses. So bad, if she's forgotten how to cry, how she gets lonely, don't know why. If she's guilty, so bad. If she's changed, I'll take the blame. If somehow she's not the same, if there's a distant look in her eyes, and she's lost. Will try if she seems better of other days, seems to have lost her Baptist ways. If the truth comes harder than a lie, if she's guilty, so am I. If she's guilty, so am I. If she's forgotten how to cry, how she gets lonely. Don't know why. If she's guilty, so am I.
Sing it, boy.
If she comes, talks to you, and asks you what she should do, we'll
give her hope
and give her help. But ask her not to blame herself. She was right more than wrong. We just weren't strong. So just hold her hand and let her cry. If she's guilty, so am I. If she's guilty, so am I. If she's forgotten how to cry, how she gets lonely, don't know why. If she's guilty, so am I. If she's guilty, so am I. If she's forgotten how to cry, how she gets lonely, don't know why. If she's guilty, so am I. So am I. So am I. So am I. So am I.
Susan, when she tried,
It gets worse in the summer when the nights are hot and long. And it's bad in December when they play those Christmas songs. If you ask me,
I don't tell you,
your sweet bottom daughter I like. Cause there's never Susan when she's crying. There's never been a woman who could make me wink inside and give me what I needed like Susan when she tried. There's never been a woman who could make me wink inside and give me what I needed like Susan when she tried. Like Susan when she tried.
So you are awake. Y'all want another one?
We don't know anymore.
Do you? You got another one up your sleeve?
I do. Yeah.
What's that?
Do you guys know Will the Circle Being Broken?
I know.
No, but you can come do it. Come on. That was not going to be next.
Yeah.
If you want to.
Come on, you know the words, sir? I will stand.
Wait a minute. What key do y'all want to do? Yeah. What key do you like saying in, JJ?
Oh, look, she's gone.
They don't have a key. That's fine. I don't know the verses.
Oh man.
Yeah.
How he does?
He wants it.
Who knows the verses?
He wants it.
If y'all want to sing your verses, come on up. Yeah.
Standing by my window on one cold and cloudy day, and I saw that hearse come rolling on to carry my mother away. Will a circle,
y'all gotta sing this,
be unbroken by and by, oh by and by. There's a feather on my wagon in the sky, Lord, in the sky.
Up when you need it.
Yeah. They sing it first. They're the ones that wanted it. Sing it first verse again.
I was standing by my window on one cold and cloudy day when I saw that hearse come rolling on to carry my mother away. Will the circle be unbroken by and by, Lord, by? There's a banner all waiting in the sky, Lord, in the sky.
One more time.
Will the circle be unbroken by and by, Lord, by and by? There's a banner all waiting in the sky, Lord, in the sky.
Yeah, that's beautiful. Do it again.
Will the circle be unbroken by and by, Lord, by and by. There's a feather home awaiting in the sky, Lord, in the sky.
Let's do it slow.
In the sky, Lord, in the sky.
Beautiful. Beautiful.
There's not a better way to end the night than that right there. That was wonderful.
Thank you so much. Y'all be safe.
God bless you. Thank you. And we will be right over here at our merchandise table. Just to let you know. We meant to plug that like an hour ago.